Welcome to English Gay Story Channel. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the like button too. Zayn didn't sleep for the entire night. How could he? He's finally gotten his parents to allow him to go spend his summer with his brother Zayad. Zayad left for university 2 years ago, and since then, their communication has been strictly text messages and phone calls. His older brother has a bit of a strangled relationship with his parents. His parents thought that he was a bad influence on Zayn. Back when Zayad still lived with them, he used to have countless girls over and threw a lot of parties. His parents have also caught him with drugs a lot of times, and it's led them to continuously fight with them. Most parents get sad when their first child is going to university, but his parents were excited. They loved their oldest son very much, but he was a handful. They were scared he would leave a negative impact on Zayn, and since then they never let Zayn go visit him, scared that he would pick up a few of Zayad's habits. But finally, after months of begging, they finally said yes. He gets to spend his entire summer with the coolest older brother in the whole world. Nothing could bring him down. "Call us anytime things get out of hand," his mother Trisha says. "Yes, mom," Zayn sighs. He heard her say this so many times. "Take care of Zayad too. I bet he's gotten skinny from not taking care of himself," she says. "I will," Zayn nods. "Can I go now? Don't want to miss the train." She nods, then envelops him in a hug. "Be careful." "Okay, mom," Zayn says as he begins to leave. Zayn is giddy the entire train ride. It is a 2-hour ride to his brother's apartment. He's listening to music on his MP3 player. He tries not to talk to anyone. This is the first time he is traveling alone due to his parents' overprotective nature. He gets out of the train, following the address that his brother sent to him by text messages, asking around when he gets confused. He finally gets the apartment building. It looks like the sketchy part of town, but he ignores that. Zayad knows what he is doing, and this is probably what he could afford. He walks up the stairs in the apartment building. The elevator was out of service, so he had no other option than to walk the long flight of stairs. He wanted to call his brother, but he also wants to surprise him. Zayad sent him his address a few days ago, and as far as he knows, Zayn is not coming up till another few weeks. He walks up to the door that says 61 and knocks at it. This is his brother's apartment according to the message that he got. He hears a bit of shuffling and the door opens. He frowns as he sees an unfamiliar looking guy on the other side of the door. "Sorry, I'm looking for Zayad," Zayn says, wondering who this person was. He's about Zayn's height with a cigarette on his lips. "You here to deliver?" he asks. Zayn shakes his head. "I think I'm at the wrong apartment." "You're looking for Zayad, isn't it?" he asks. Zayn nods. "Yeah." "Then you are in right place," he says. "But he ain't home. Come back some other time." "I don't have anywhere else to go," Zayn says, rubbing the back of his head awkwardly. Well, this isn't what he planned. He thought he would knock at the door and his brother would be at the other side, surprised but happy to see him. And they had spent all the day catching up on all they have missed. "Not my problem," he says, trying to close the door, but Zayn intervenes. "He's my brother, all right? I'll just wait for him inside," Zayn says. "You are Zayn?" the guy asks, a different expression on his face. Zayn notes, "Wait, how did you know?" The guy opens the door fully for him to come in. "Well, why didn't you say so in the first place? Hope I didn't give you any trouble." Zad's gonna kick my ass if I did. I'm Louis, by the way, his best friend. Oh, you are Louis, Jen asked, pretending that Zayad has mentioned him before, even though this is the first time he's ever hearing of that name. He didn't even know what his older brother had a best friend. He thought that they told each other everything. Yep, the one and only, he winks at him. So you are baby, Zad's always on the phone with. First we thought he was hiding a girlfriend from us. But it turned out to be his little brother. Zen's smile, he won't stop calling me pet names. It's nice to know he has a softer side, Louis says. Do you live here with him? Zen asks. He didn't know that his brother had roommates either. He never mentioned it on the phone. Nah, just keeping the house warm while he does business, Louis says. He'll be back soon. Zen yawns. Okay. Sleepy? He asks. Go take a nap in Zad's room. Zen shakes his head. I want to surprise him when he comes. Suit yourself, Louis says. Zayan tries to stay awake as he waits for his older brother so he could run up to him when he comes. Throw the door and look at the expression on his face. But he can't help but falling asleep. When he wakes up, he finds himself in a bedroom. It looks like a different from the rest of the house. It's much neater and well decorated. How did I get here? He mumbles to himself. I carried your sleepy little ass, babe. He hears a familiar voice by the door and he turns and finds his brother. He can't contain his smile when he sees him and he screams, running up to him and jumping on his body. Zayad, he says, as his older and bigger brother holds him in his arms. He can't help it when tears fall on his back. Zayad laughs, hugging him harder. I see you are still crybaby. Shut up, I wanted to surprise you, Zan sniffles. Well, I was certainly surprised when I walked in and I saw you sleeping on my couch, Jazz says. I missed you so much, Meri Jaan. You've grown so big. They pull apart while Zayad takes the opportunity to admire his little brother who he hasn't seen in so long. I still look like the same, Zan mumbles. His brother shakes his head. You were 14 the last time I saw you. You've certainly grown taller. And is that facial hair I am detecting? He teases. Zen folds his hands, knowing that he was being made fun of. He doesn't have facial hair yet, not even a hint of it. He's completely hairless, and when Zayad was his age, he knows his brother was already packing a full beard. I'm just messing with you, babe, Zayad says. Come on. You must be starving. Let's go get dinner. Can I cook? Jens offer. He loves cooking. It's a habit he's picked up by recently, and he wants to show his brother how much he's improved. We have to go grocery shopping tomorrow for that. But for now, I ordered Chinese, Jens says. Again, Jens says he loves Chinese food and he's genuinely starving. Jayad leads him out of the room. Don't say anything to the guys in the living room, Zayad warns. Why not? Zen asks. Just don't, Zayad insists. He walks into the living room with the older brother, holding him by the waist. There are two guys sitting in the living room. He can't find Louis, so he's probably gone. The other guys are watching The Simpsons on the TV. One immediately strikes his attention. He's incredibly attractive, and he immediately looks away when the guy looks back at him. The other guy lets out of a wolf whistle. Who's this Zad? He asks. This is baby, Zad says. Aren't you gonna introduce us? The same guy asks, staring at Zayan more intensely. Zayan looks away, feeling a bit uncomfortable when he moves closer to his brother's side. Nah, and if I catch you staring at him again, I'm stabbing you in the eye, Zayad warns. The guy shivers. Jan finds his eyes still trailing to the other handsome guy that still hasn't said a word yet. Jan would really like to hear him, but Zayad told him not to say anything. Zayad sits down on the couch and pulls Jan to sit on his lap as they join his friends to watch the show. Where's Louis? Jan asks. Damn, If I know, Zaid responds. Is he really your best friend? Zain whispers. Zaid laughs. Is that what he told you? I swear he is obsessed with me. Could he be your boyfriend then? Zain teases. He wishes. His older brother replies. Zain chuckles. Turning his head and find the guy he was staring at earlier, now staring at him. He can't help his cheeks going red. Who is this guy? He's very attractive. He's got dark hair and bushy eyebrows. He's also got a few tattoos picking up on his sleeves, but not that much. Jayan doesn't know what to call him since Zayad didn't introduce him. They stare at each other for a bit before Zayad notices and pinches at Jayan's side, causing him to shriek at the unexpected pain. Don't, Zayad commands. I didn't do anything, Zayan says. Keep it that way, Zayad says. Jayan scoffs internally. He forgot how overprotective his older brother was. He just want to hear handsome speak, and maybe his short infatuation would be over. It's like his mind is being read and handsome stands up from the couch, tall. That's what Jayan notices immediately. He's much taller than anyone else in the room, including his brother that was about 6 feet. The other guy stands up too, but Zayan doesn't really pay attention to him, leaving Zayad ask. He nods, still not saying a word. Zayan finds that frustrating. Why won't he just speak, damn it? Same time tomorrow, handsome says. Finally he's speaking, but his words do nothing to quell Zayan's infatuation. In fact, his infatuation more than doubles due to how good he sounds. Zayad nods, alright man, bye. Then they leave. The Zayan feels so unsatisfied. A few minutes later, their food arrives and him and Zayad eat together. So who were they? Zayan asks. Some guys I work with, Zayad says. What kind of work? Zayan asks. Nothing to worry your pretty little head about. His older responds, tapping at Zayan's forehead. Zayan frowns. Ever since he walked up into Zayad's apartment, he's had a funny feeling that his brother is doing something that isn't quite legal. Louis asks him if he was here to deliver. Is his brother buying or selling drugs? Whatever it is, he is going to find out soon. Zayad may be older, but he wants to take care of him too.